Hi there, this is René Modena for GNS Threefold, and I'd like to show you how to solve the BGP regular expressions lab. And this one is going to be fun because this is the only lab where we don't use any routers, at least nothing in GNS 3 or real routers, because I like to use a public route server or a looking glass server. And those are routers on the internet. You can telnet to them and you can just take a look at some BGP tables. So let's see if we can find anything. So I'm going to this website, bgp4.as. And here we have a couple of looking glass servers. So you can see we got a couple of routers here, and let's pick something close for me. That's Germany, perhaps. And see if we can see anything here. Let me change my settings a bit. Just to make sure it's a bit more easy to read for you guys. There we go, that should be better. Okay, so what I did, this is one of the looking glass servers, and you can do a show IP BGP, and what you have here is an example of a internet routing table, and you can see there's plenty of prefixes here, so we have a lot of information which is fun to play with regular expressions. So let's see if we can solve this. So, for example, let's see if AS3491 is available here. And we'll start with this regular expression. I want something that only shows AS3491. So, let's see if that is possible. So, I can do show IP BGP, a regular expression. And let's see if there is some information about this AS. Here we go, plenty. So these are all networks or prefixes that are from this AS number. Because over here, on the right side, you only see the AS number over here. So that's the first regular expression that we have. Let me show it again. So that's the caret symbol, AS number, and a dollar. That's the first one. Let's do another one. A regular expression that shows AS3491 at the beginning and everything behind it. So here's an example. So at the front, 3491, and then everything behind it. Let's see if we can find something like that. And there we go. So it starts with the caret symbol, AS number, and then the underscore. And now you see all this information with 3491 in front of it. So that's looking good. What else do we have? A regular expression that shows all networks that originate in AS3491. Now, how can we do this? We can do it like this. There we go. So you can see if 3491 is on the right side, then that's where that prefix has originated. And for example, those prefixes over here, in order to get there, we need to go through AS1299 through 3549, and then we'll end up in 3491. So this is the regular expression that you need to use. What else do we have? Something that only shows the locally originated network, so from our own AS. We can do that as well. Here we go. So these are all the networks from our own autonomous system. They are originated in this autonomous system. So that's this regular expression, the caret symbol, and then a dollar. Another one. A regular expression that shows everything where AS3491 is in the middle of the AS path. You can do it like this. And now I have all the information where 3491 is within the path. So far, so good. Now the last one, create a regular expression that shows all networks that are originated by your directly connected AS neighbors. So I'm not specifying which AS neighbor, just any directly connected neighbor that you have. You want to see the networks that are originated by them. And let me think, that should be something like this. There we go. So now you get to see all of the prefixes that are originated by all the directly connected autonomous systems that I have. And this is the regular expression that you need to use. And that was the last one. So that's all of the regular expressions that we have, and these are some of the ones that they're pretty common to use every now and then. So I hope you enjoyed this video. And of course, regular expressions are very useful when you start playing with BGP. So if you want to do some BGP labs, make sure to go to gns3vault.com and go to the lab section. So far, thank you for watching.